Good morning, everyone. You are now watching a video. It's not a normal review because you can find already a lot of reviews of this aircraft on YouTube, but it's more a virtual reality review of this aircraft. So, on this video, I will speak about the subjects that matters on virtual reality. For all the other things, to show you how good is the aircraft, it's not here that you will find those things. Another really important things that I have to tell you before continue on this video. What you are seeing now is a recording of a 2D flight that I'm gonna do now, because I tried many times to do something to record the video when I was flying with the headset on virtual reality, but the rendering wasn't good for a YouTube video. So I will tell you my thoughts and feelings about the virtual reality on this video, but what you are seeing now is not a 3D flight with virtual reality. So the first thing that I will tell you is what you can or can't do with this aircraft on virtual reality. So if you are already a virtual reality user, you know that all that windows, that kind of windows, you can't see them in virtual reality. But it's maybe important for those of you who never use an headset before. So sometimes you have to pull off your headset to set up the things here. So my advice is to set up those kind of things before doing your flight. Another things that I have to thing that I have to do to tell you is about here on the virtual cockpit. As you can see, it's the same on virtual reality. All the aircraft is rendering very well. It's a masterpiece in terms of graphism. It's really nice to see how it is. But the thing is that on virtual reality, almost everything gets an high resolution. But maybe it's because of my setups, but for me, this area here, the pedals here, the floor, and just next to the overhead panel, those areas are in a very low resolution, and it's less good for immersion. But for all the other things, everything is in very high resolution, and it's a real pleasure to fly this aircraft because everything looks awesome and it's stunning. This aircraft, I will tell you that now, is on my top 3 of my favorite virtual reality aircraft in X-Plane 11, and it's important to say X-Plane 11. The beacon. What I also have to tell you, what about immersion? Because it's really important, I think, in virtual reality, because we purchase this kind of headset for that, for the immersion. Let me tell you that the immersion is really good with this aircraft. And why? Because the performance are good, but I will speak about that later on. Also, because everything is rendering and is good and is well modelized. It's something really important that I will say to you. This important thing is that everything is easily readable everywhere, and that's something that you can't find on every aircraft. Per example, here on the overhead panel, on a few aircrafts, not every aircraft, but on a good amount of aircraft, payware or freeware, you can't see easily what's written on the overhead panel or on your PFDs, GPS, airspeed indicator, altitude indicator. And here you can easily find all the informations that you are needing without helped to make a zoom like that with your mouse or with your head, just in the direction of your screen. And it's really good because you can be comfortable on your seat and see everything like in real. So keep in mind that it's virtual reality, so it won't be as clear as it is on 2D flight, but let me tell you that it's one of the aircraft that renders the most the better everything that you have to read and the informations. You can easily read your airspeed here or here, which is more little, or your altitude, the things written here, the GPS, what is here, also the overhead. And it's very important, especially for the immersion, because like that you can do with this aircraft, you can do almost everything of your flight, I will say 90% of your flight, with the headset on your head, and you don't have to pull off your headset often. That's something that sometimes you have to do with other aircraft, and that's not really good for the immersion, but here it's not the case, and it's something very, very good. What can I also tell you about immersion? Yeah, the sounds are pretty nice. I'm used to let the sound of the Oculus Rift when I'm flying in virtual reality, and they are rendering very good with the headset. I know that some people are flying, even when they are flying in virtual reality, with another headset for the sound, or with a home cinema soundbar. But even with the default speakers of your Oculus Rift, I don't know for HTC Vive, but even with the default Oculus Rift speakers, it's really good. And yeah, that's a pleasure to fly, to hear, to everything. Also, yeah, the graphics are very good. And I will now speak about performances, because performances are really important in virtual reality. It's really important every time on a flight simulator to don't have a slideshow. But I think that it's even more important on virtual reality, because if you are not a virtual reality user, I will just tell you that if you don't have good FPS, it will break the immersion, but it can also get you some motion sickness. And yeah, after 5 minutes with the headset on your head, it will be not comfortable. And it's not the case with this aircraft, because the performance are really good. If you already own the Pipistrel Pantera, also from Aerobasque, you can compete with it, and the performance are the same. So they are really good, because when you are keeping in mind that those aircraft are very in-depth and with very good integration of GTN 750 and 650. Yes, when you keep that in mind, you can just be surprised how it performs well. In comparison with stock aircraft, I will take the Cessna 172. Obviously, it's heavier on FPS than the Cessna, but not too much. And trust me, you can really fly this aircraft on your most scenic and heavier scenery without any problem. I assume that because if you already own a VR headset, that's because you have a good computer and good specifications. So yes, if you have the computers to run a virtual reality headset, you will run smoothly this aircraft on virtual reality, get your 90 FPS on your headset easily, and that's really good to know. But yeah, that's something that I forgot to say, and it's really important. It's about immersion and what you can't do on this aircraft. You know, with the Oculus Rift, I don't know about HTC Vive and Loop Motion, but with the Oculus Rift, we've got the Oculus Touch controllers. With 95% of my aircraft, X-Plane 11 and also Aerofly FS2 or P3D V4, I can, if I want, set up the aircraft and switch the buttons. So coming with a cold enough aircraft to a ready to fly aircraft, just with my hands and with the virtual, with my virtual hands, thanks to the touch controllers. But I don't know why on this aircraft that's not working. It's working on the Aerobus Upstrel Pantera, so the same editor, but here I don't know why it is not. Keep in mind also that VR is not officially supported natively by X-Plane. Maybe that when we will have the native support, it's gonna work. But for the moment, it is not. I don't know why, but yeah, for the moment, it's not. I think that it's almost everything. Keep also in mind that I'm speaking about my experience in VR. Virtual reality, and also with my computer's specification, so maybe that it's gonna be totally different on your aircraft. I can't guarantee you that you will have the same smoothness that I've got, the same rendering and the same experience, but it's also good to know that I'm a really new user of virtual reality, and I'm not mastering for the moment the setup and the tricks to have a really good experience of virtual reality. So maybe that it can be better and better than what is it for the moment for me. But to be honest, for the moment I'm really enjoying this aircraft. It's maybe the first, it's the first flight that I'm doing with this aircraft on 2D, because when you are used to flying in 3D with the VR headset, you won't fly anymore in 2D. But for the purposes of this video, I did it in 2D. But I will land as soon as possible and grab this aircraft back on 3D. So I hope that you enjoyed this video, even if my English is not quite perfect. I tried to do my best. I did this video just to help the community to help those of you who are hesitating before buying this aircraft. But don't hesitate too much. It's worth the price. If you already have the Upstrel Pantera, you have a good comparison, because those aircraft performs this the same on my computer, so maybe that it's gonna be the same on yours. So yes, that's it, and I hope that you enjoyed the video, and see you maybe